Do you struggle with getting onto the dance floor and dancing in front of your friends or strangers? After watching this video, you'll know exactly what to do and you'll have a strategy you can follow to build confidence for dancing in social settings. For the best social dance tutorials and advice, please subscribe to this channel, hit the notifications bell so you're notified whenever I'm posting a new video every week. If you're new to my channel, hi, my name is Monica. I help men and women feel better, get the skills and feel confident when dancing in social settings. If you are one of those people who are anxious about dancing in front of others, you're feeling stressed or nervous about it, you just don't like it and you'd like to fix it, I'm happy to announce that a few spots have opened up for a free one-on-one consultation with me. If you would like to set it up, wait till the end of this video, I'll tell you exactly how to do it then. First thing I want you to realize that you're not alone in this. There's literally thousands of people just like you, people who are self-conscious about dancing in front of other people. And you might be thinking, how do I know that? Well, for the past 15 years, this has been my full-time job, teaching adults how to become just better, how to get that confidence, how to stop being self-conscious. Literally, thousands of my people, I was able to help thousands of clients using my strategy, and I wanted to share a little bit of that with you today, and you can go right here to see some of their stories. Okay, let's get into the strategy because there's a lot to talk about. First of all, what we need is a mindset shift. And you might be wondering, Monica, okay, I need the moves. Yes, but before that, everything depends on mindset. Your entire learning process, your learning experience, how successful you will be at learning how to dance is your mindset. I know right now, dancing in front of other people, when other people are watching you, is this big, scary thing. You're not going to be in the middle of the dance floor, dancing by yourself, performing for 100 people, you know, sitting around and watching you like this. That's not what you're going to the club for. We have this image in our head like this, we're going to be on display. Everyone's eyes will be on us. No, you will be in a crowd of people, right? So there will be lots of people on the dance floor with you, and you don't have to be great. You don't have to be a good dancer. You don't have to stand out. You just have to blend in. You don't have to be extraordinary. You don't have to be an amazing dancer. You just have to be good enough. And that's less scary, right? Good enough, we can accomplish that. There's not much to it. It shouldn't take you years. We just need to look natural and blend in, do what other people are doing. If you approach it like that, good enough is not out of your reach. Everyone can be good enough. And of course, we'll get good later. Why not? But it will be less scary if you just start small, right? Okay, I'm going to tell you how exactly you can start building up that confidence, and we'll have entire strategy that you can follow. But before we do that, let me know in the comments, are you one of those people who is anxious and just not liking getting onto the dance floor when, you know, other people are watching? Do you struggle with that? Hand up if that's you. Maybe I can create more videos that will help you break out of this. Okay, now we know that mindset is everything, but what can you actually do physically to start getting over this anxiety when it comes to dancing? Let's start with baby steps. Number two is baby steps. You will not, I repeat, you will not just wake up one day not scared to dance in front of other people. If this is something that you've been struggling with for years, it's just not going to happen. We have to take little steps towards getting confident. And fortunately, this is something that anyone can do. So tell me, maybe you are one of those people who have been learning by yourself for weeks, following, you know, tutorials on YouTube, maybe months, but the moves that you learned, you're still not finding yourself doing them in the club, let's say. Why is that? This is because you're working on the dance moves. You're working on building this bank of moves. It has nothing to do with your confidence. So you will start building the confidence once you're putting the actions with the environment those actions are meant for. This is what no one is telling you when it comes to learning how to dance. To accomplish something that right now feels super uncomfortable, you're dreading it, you have to do gradually slightly less uncomfortable actions to get you there. So baby steps, right? And this is how you build the confidence. It's a gradual process, but it is a process. You won't just wake up knowing how to dance in front of all those people. This is what I want you to try. So maybe you're learning on YouTube from my channel, hopefully, maybe somebody else. You are playing the video and you're just copying the movements along with the video. And that somehow got already comfortable, right? You're okay doing it. You're used to it. But think about it, in the club, you're not going to have a video to follow. So let's do something a little bit more uncomfortable, something new. The movement that you learned, try to turn on the video and just do it on your own. Maybe try it to a different song, the song that's not playing with the tutorial. See if you can match the step that you learned to a totally new song. Because again, in the club, you're not controlling the music most of the time, unless you're the DJ. Mind you, this will be uncomfortable in the beginning because it's new, because it's something you haven't been doing, and it will take some time getting used to. But just how you got used to and you got comfortable with following the tutorial in the video, you will get comfortable doing the movements on your own. Or another thing you can try, maybe you are used to learning just one dance move at a time from a tutorial. This time try to remember what you did a week ago and connect the two movements together. So play a song and see if you can transition between the two movements. You'll start with two, eventually there will be three, 10, 15, and that's how you'll be able to slowly build up your freestyle skills, right? Again, that's what we need to do in the club. You will be required to transition between the steps. Practice that at home. Remember, this is not going to happen overnight. Those steps, this strategy is supposed to make you uncomfortable. But give it a week. If not a week, give it a month, and I promise you it will work because you're working towards the goal, which is freestyling comfortably in the club. Let's pick something that you can practice in the club when you're in front of other people. Okay, so I'm not a fan of choreography and having an entire routine prepared, because that's not what you're going to do in the club. You're not going there to perform in front of all those people. And the goal is to blend in, right? And you cannot blend in doing something totally different than something that all of those people on the dance floor are doing. They are freestyling, they just are improvising. So we have to work towards that. However, if you've never danced in front of other people in the club, having a tiny little, I call them clusters of moves prepared might help you. A mini sequence of 3 to 4 steps that you will practice ahead of time and that you will later on use in the club. And this will help you build confidence because you will know those 3-4 steps 100%. Those will be the steps that you know feel good and you know look good on you. If you want to learn from my channel, I have a club dance playlist that I'm going to link below. Those are just videos with one move per video. You can pick 3, let's say, or 4, and just create your own little routine. I also have a hip hop playlist where in one video you have 3 moves, so it's already kind of pre-planned for you. I'm going to link it below this video as well. And number 3 in our strategy, and I must admit this, I would not be myself if I didn't mention this, because I truly believe this is the best way to build confidence for dancing in social settings, is to create or build permanent dance skills. Nothing beats that. Once you build permanent dance skills, you will be prepared for dancing at any social dance event for the rest of your life. You can learn some dance moves here and there, but this is just a temporary fix. It will just mean that you know some dance moves. It will not mean that you know how to dance. And if you want to be very confident and comfortable dancing, you know, for the rest of your life at any social dance event ahead in your future, you have to have a proper solid dance foundation. For club dancing or dancing in the club or in social settings, we need 3 things. We need rhythm, we need coordination, and we need ability to freestyle, to improvise. Here are their advantages. So first of all, you only need to learn how to dance and develop those skills once in your life, just one time, if you're doing it right, and you will be ready for any social dance event ahead. You will be able to, once you have those permanent skills, especially rhythm, you will be able to dance to any song, right? Not in one song in a tutorial that's playing, but to anything that the DJ happens to play, right? You will be able to match any movement that you've learned to any song. Now, that's freedom, right? Having permanent dance skills also means that you will never run out of moves. Only if you're 100% sure that you're doing something correctly, you will not hesitate to do that in front of people. You won't care that people are watching. You know that you have the skills, you know you got this. Right now you're questioning if what you're learning, maybe on YouTube, let's say, is even correct, right? You're questioning if you're looking the same as the teacher showing the moves. Am I right? There's many ways you can build permanent dance skills. There's private dance lessons. I recommend that because you need one-on-one feedback. There is dance courses like mine. Hello. That's what I do for thousands of people each day, every day. I do not recommend group lessons. There's no feedback from the teacher. You're pretty much on your own. And I do not recommend YouTube to start with because there's just too much. It's not a program. It's not step by step. You don't know where to start. You don't have the feedback again. So this will lead to more confusion and more hesitation, and you won't do those moves in front of other people. If you'd like to develop permanent dance skills and build the confidence for any social dance event in your future, I'm sure there will be a lot of those, I opened up a few spots for free one-on-one consultation with me. And if you'd like to sign up, there's a 2-minute survey. I'm going to put a link below this video. You're going to fill out the survey, just a few questions, and it will lead to a calendar where you can book your session with me. And I'm looking forward to speaking with you and helping you because this is fixable. And check out some students that are currently in my program. For example, Juliana, who now can dance and she's making her dreams come true. Check out Jordan, who thought that learning how to dance is just not for him. And now he's enjoying dancing every single day. Omkar, who avoided dancing his entire life. And now, look at that, no fear. Let me know, you guys, if this was helpful. I'll be happy to create more videos just like this one, which is, you know, less about the dance moves and more about the techniques and the tricks and the tips and advices. So if you like this video, don't forget to click the like button and share it with your friends. Maybe you know someone who needs my help. Subscribe to my channel, hit the bell to be notified when I'm posting a new video every week. And thank you so much for watching and learning from me. As always, I'll see you in the next video. Bye. I've lost you, but I need you, and you're off my radar now.